Hey, I'm Stephen and this is Solving the Money Problem. If you're new, welcome. If you're not, welcome back. 12 years ago, Tesla released their first product, the original Roadster. Its goal? To prove an electric vehicle could compete with gasoline on performance, features, and utility, and as a way for Tesla to develop its technology, drive down costs, and pave the way for future products. The high-priced, low-volume Roadster did its job, and 4 years later, Tesla unveiled its second-generation vehicle, the Model S sedan, which went on to take the world by storm and win every award ever. I'm not even joking. Soon after, came Model X. But these were all stepping stones to the final destination, a mass-market, high-volume, low-cost vehicle. The third generation began with the critically acclaimed Model 3 in 2017, and in 2020, the puzzle was completed with the Model Y. Tesla is on its way to total domination of the global vehicle market. Yes, there's still a long way to go in terms of ramping production from hundreds of thousands to millions of vehicles per year, but Tesla has won. Their technology is embarrassingly far ahead of everyone else. If you question this, maybe watch a 7-seater Model X SUV take on a Lambo or Ferrari on the track. Or check in on how VW's ID.3 project is going. Nothing else in the same price range comes even close on performance, features, utility, safety, or efficiency. Not even close. However, the last stronghold is the ultra-high performance market. You know, the $2 million inch-adding supercars, hypercars, and whatever the fuck else you want to call them. Guess what? They're next. In Elon Musk's own words.
The point of doing this is to just give the hardcore smackdown to gasoline cars.
Tesla's 2020 Roadster is a gigantic fuck you to gasoline vehicles. All of them. Its aim is unequivocally to absolutely annihilate the performance metrics of every gasoline vehicle ever made. Not just be close or on par, but to destroy them. This will get the world's attention. So in this video, I'm explaining why the Roadster will directly and indirectly make Tesla billions and end the ice age once and for all. Hey guys, we will have an awesome offer for US residents. You can get a free stock just by opening an account and a second free stock valued up to $1,400 by funding your account with $100 using the link below. And if you're in Australia, New Zealand or the UK, you can get a free stock with Stake, also linked in the description. Let's get back to it. Performance. Usually when the terms performance and 2 seconds appear close by, it's in reference to a disappointing showing at the Bedroom Olympics. But in the world of high performance vehicles, the faster, the better. No production vehicle in history has achieved a 0 to 60 time of under 2 seconds. Until now. Let's listen to what Elon had to say at the Roadster unveil.
Driving a gasoline sports car is going to feel like a steam engine with a side of quiche. The new Tesla Roadster will be the fastest production car ever made, period. This is the base model. I wouldn't say what the actual top speed is, but it's above 250 miles an hour. These numbers sound nutty, but they're real. 620 mile range, that's a 1,000 kilometer range. This will be the first time an electric vehicle breaks 1,000 kilometers. A production electric vehicle will travel more than 1,000 kilometers in a single charge at highway speed. You'll be able to travel from LA to San Francisco and back at highway speed without recharging.
The specs for the base model Roadster are difficult to believe. A 0 to 60 time of under 2 seconds, a range of over 600 miles, or 1,000 kilometers for those of you who don't use the world's dopiest measurement system, seating for 4, the world's best active safety features. I could go on. Most of you have never experienced 0 to 60 in 2 seconds, or even 3 seconds. Let me tell you, it's absurd. It doesn't feel right at all. How do I know? Shortly after the Roadster reveal, I visited a theme park in Australia with a ride called Superman Escape, which does 0 to 60 in 2 seconds flat. It's something else. You are guaranteed to swear, groan, grunt, scream, and possibly fill your pantaloons when experiencing that level of acceleration. The Roadster is literally a mobile f***ing roller coaster. And that's just the base model. Since the unveiling, Tesla have shaved a tenth of a second off the quarter mile time and continue to improve their battery technology. Who knows what the final production version will be capable of? Ludicrous. Rocket thrusters. Imagine being the CEO of two multi-billion dollar companies, one of which makes electric vehicles, solar and batteries, and the other which makes reusable rockets and satellites. I've just described Elon Musk. This comes in handy for cross-pollination. Tesla's internet-breaking Cybertruck is made from a special steel developed by SpaceX for its rockets. And the Roadster? There's an optional upgrade for a SpaceX thruster package. Seriously. You will be able to equip the Tesla Roadster with cold gas thrusters. What exactly are these? Let's watch a clip of a Falcon 9 rocket re-entering Earth's atmosphere. See those jets of what look like steam? They're cold gas thrusters. Notice their ability to reorient this gigantic fucking rocket as it plunges towards Earth? That rocket is about the size of a 30-story building. My point? These thrusters are no joke. In fact, Elon Musk has confirmed that the Roadster will, theoretically, be able to do short hops or even fly. Yes, fly. What the actual f**k? However, the thrusters aren't just for party tricks. They're like a cheat code in a video game. You can break the rules, and it's just not fair. It's practically impossible to accelerate from 0 to 60 faster than 2 seconds because physics. Traction matters, and tires become the limiting factor at these speeds. If acceleration is too fast, tires can't grip, and you'll go nowhere. Enter rocket thrusters. Because these can be mounted anywhere, such as behind the license plate, traction is no longer relevant. If you want to get down in the weeds with the Roadster's thrusters, Engineering Explained made a great video which I'll link below. In short, with thrusters on board, it seems possible the Roadster will be able to do 0 to 60 in just over 1 second, twice as fast as anything else ever produced. But it doesn't end there. Safety. We're told the SpaceX package will seamlessly surround the Roadster with about 10 thrusters. We already know Tesla makes the 3 safest vehicles ever tested. This is not a debate, but a fact. No doubt, Tesla will ensure the Roadster is incredibly safe in the event of a collision too. But what about collision avoidance? Tesla's autopilot and active safety features make them among the least likely vehicles to be involved in accidents. And over time, autopilot continues to improve and become even safer. So far, so good. Nothing surprising here. But with rocket thrusters, things get interesting. While it may be legally questionable today, humor me for a moment. Tesla could use the gas thrusters as active safety features. If an impact is imminent, thrusters on the front of the Roadster could decelerate the vehicle at insane speeds to dramatically reduce the impact or avoid it altogether. Same too if you're about to be rear-ended. In the span of just over 1 second, your Roadster could accelerate you to 60 miles an hour and avoid a collision. Things get very interesting when we consider how side, front, and rear thrusters could be used to improve handling too. These features may initially be relegated to private tracks, but if Tesla can make the case for improved safety, it's not impossible to imagine the Roadster being one of the world's safest vehicles. Unmatched handling, braking, acceleration, and collision avoidance. This isn't baseless speculation on my part. In Elon's own words, these rocket engines dramatically improve acceleration, top speed, braking, and cornering. What a flex. Value, not cost. Starting at $200,000 for the base model and $250,000 for the limited edition Founders Series, the 2020 Roadster ain't cheap, but when compared to vehicles which boast similar but inferior performance, it's a steal. The fastest production vehicle of all time is the two-seat hybrid Porsche 918 Spyder with a 0-60 time of 2.1 seconds. And the price? A cool $845,000 for the base model. They only made 918 of them too. One Roadster or 4 Spiders? One all-electric or a gas-guzzling hybrid? A 4-seater or a 2-seater? 620-mile range or 420-mile? Rocket thrusters or no rocket thrusters? Tesla's Roadster wins on every metric. That's embarrassing. And that's the point. The 2020 Roadster isn't about Roadster itself. It's about its impact on the internal combustion engine vehicle market. It's Tesla's way of saying, why are you morons still using gasoline when electric can do this? Let me guess, you've got a new model of horse and carriage coming out soon too. When Tesla's new Roadster is eventually released, it's the end of ICE, the final nail in the coffin. The only appeal gasoline supercars will have beyond that? Novelty and aesthetics. Objectively speaking, much like the Model S is the best luxury sedan ever, and the Model 3 is the best mid-size sedan, the new Roadster will unequivocally be the best sports slash supercar ever. By miles. Get it? Miles? The numbers. As a Tesla investor and shareholder, this is my favorite part of the video. Because Roadster is first a flex and second a product, Tesla doesn't need to sell hundreds of thousands. Its primary job is to draw attention to Tesla, electric vehicles, and shame internal combustion engine vehicles into obsolescence. Regardless, representing such tremendous value, you know, a quarter or a tenth of the price of a comparable yet inferior supercar, I suspect sales of Roadster may surprise to the upside. Rather than looking at the total number of supercars and hypercars sold every year, it's better to look at the total dollar value of this market, which does about $15 billion in sales annually. Given that Roadster will be unequivocally better than anything else money can buy, I expect over time it will take a disproportionately large share of this market. I mean, if you've got a few $2 million hypercars in your garage, What's a 200k Roadster? What's more, I believe the Roadster will entice buyers from lower price points too, just as the Model 3 has captured many Honda and Toyota buyers due to its tremendous value. I mean, how does one justify spending $180,000 on a Porsche Taycan when you can buy the Roadster for 10% more and get triple the range, half the 0 to 60 time, blah blah. You get the point. Even in the domain of absurdly expensive performance vehicles, some reasoning applies. Cheaper and worse is a challenge, but significantly cheaper and significantly better in every way? It's hard to argue with that. If Tesla captures just 10% of the global supercar market, they're looking at $1.5 billion in revenue, or just 7,500 base model Roadsters. Pretty serious business for a high-end toy, especially given the profit margins on Roadster will be unquestionably massive. And the free press Roadster has and will generate for Tesla, ultimately boosting sales of its core products? Priceless. Roadster investment? One final thought before I wrap up. This isn't investment advice, just me thinking out loud. Tesla is making 1,000 Founders Series Roadsters. At $250,000 a pop, they're not cheap, and buyers need to pony up the full price just to make a reservation. But what are the odds that in 5, 10, or 20 years, these become a collector's item? The car that melted ice for good, limited to just 1,000. Food for thought. To sum it up, the 2020 Roadster is the final frontier and the ultimate flex. Its goal is not to compete with supercars, but to murder them in their sleep. Nothing short of total domination. On price, value, performance, features, safety, and utility, Roadster is in a class of its own and will embarrass everything else on the market. The 2020 Roadster marks the end of the Ice Age. The internal combustion engine is dead. Roadster is to performance vehicles what the automobile was to the horse and carriage. This matters. And don't forget your free stocks with Webull and Stake. Links in description. I'm Stephen Mark Ryan. This is Solving the Money Problem, and I love you all. Thanks so much for watching. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Do you agree or disagree? Is Roadster the final nail in the coffin for ICE vehicles? Will you buy one? And of course, if you have any ideas for future videos, let me know. I read all your comments. P.S. If you're still watching, you're awesome. If you'd like to access exclusive videos, regular Q&As, behind-the-scenes content, and more, consider supporting the channel at patreon.com/solvingthemoneyproblem so I can keep creating content for you guys. There's a link in the description, and you can now also become a member of the channel for some exclusive perks. To learn more, click the join button next to subscribe. Either way, the best form of support is you being here and watching, so thanks again.